In this video series, we will give an overview of how to make graphs and analyze your data with GraphPad Prism. For these videos, we will be using the latest version of Prism, which is currently version number 6. Even if you possess a different version of Prism or use Prism on a different kind of computer, the concepts covered here will still be helpful for understanding the software and learning how to use it. As you will see in these videos, Prism is a really great program for making publication quality graphs. It is very powerful and at the same time quite intuitive once you learn the basics of how to use it. If you've never tried Prism before, you can test it out with a free 30-day trial by clicking on the link below or in the video description. When you first open Prism, the welcome dialog appears, which asks you to choose an appropriate type of a table and a graph for your data. You can see to the left that Prism has 6 different table and graph types to choose from. And each one has a different set of options to select before the table and the graph can be created. For first-time users of GraphPad Prism, this is probably the most intimidating part of the software, because until now, if you have worked with simpler spreadsheet software like Excel, you've probably never been asked from the start of a program to choose between different kinds of tables. So you might be asking yourself, what's the difference between all these tables? Why do I even have to choose a specific type of table in order for me to graph my data? So the purpose of this first video is to answer those very important questions and to walk you through the choices that you see here. By doing that, it's going to make it much easier for you to figure out which choice you should make and understand how that decision is going to make your life much easier when it comes to graphing and analyzing your data. As you can see here, the default table and graph type is that of an XY plot. The little image at the top of this window shows you how a graph of this type might look. It also lists below the most common analyses that you'll be performing with this kind of data table, because each kind of table has its own type of analysis, and that's one of the reasons why it's so important to choose the right type of table from the beginning, because it affects how you analyze your data as well as how you graph it. So an XY graph is ideal for plotting data like a standard curve, where you want to show the relationship between two variables, such as concentration on the x-axis and absorbance on the y-axis. You can see to the right that there are 4 options for you to choose from when you want to make an XY graph, and one is related to the x-axis, and 3 choices are for the y-axis. In the next video, we will demonstrate how to make an XY graph, and then it will become clear what effect these choices will have on your data table and graph. The next tab is for a column table and graph, and you can see that this is ideal for comparing a single variable between different groups. This would be useful, for example, if you are looking at something like protein expression and you want to compare different treatment groups at a single time point. Then there are grouped tables and graphs. So these sort of graphs would be ideal if you want to plot one type of variable like weight or height, and you want to graph that for different groups such as males or females, and not only different groups but different treatment conditions within those groups, such as the control and the treatment group that you see here. Another common use for a grouped table and a graph is if you want to plot single measurements such as gene expression for different treatment groups at different time points. So, for example, the first group could be your time 0 measurements, and the other time point would be grouped one after the other in a way that compares all of those different treatments for each of those time points. A contingency graph is much like a group graph, but the main difference is that your data are exact counts, such as data from a survey. Hence, you can see that there are no error bars in this type of graph, since the results are all precise numbers. A survival graph is most commonly used to show the rate of decline in the population of different experimental groups, such as in cancer experiments. However, a survival graph can really be used to show the amount of time it takes for any one-time event, which doesn't necessarily have to be death. Prism makes it very easy to graph this type of data too. And finally, under the Parts of a Whole tab, you can create a pie chart, which is useful when you want to compare different groups that make up part of a whole, such as groups in a population like males and females as shown here. So once you have selected the type of table and graph that you would like to use, you'll have to make a couple of selections in the center part, as we said earlier. And finally, you would click Create in order to start inputting your data and making the graph. One word of caution is that you don't want to make the mistake of flying through the welcome dialog just so you can get started with your data. If you pick the right kind of table for your data, your graphing and analysis will go very smoothly. If you pick the wrong kind of table, you might struggle with trying to graph your data for a few minutes and then realize that you started off wrong and you'll probably have to switch to a different type of a table. So with that said, changing table types is really not that big of a deal, even after you've passed the welcome dialog. If you happen to make the wrong selection the first time you give this a try, all you have to do is click on this little button under the Change panel, and you'll be brought back to the same menu so that you can make a different selection. However, if you've already started inputting your data, when you click on this button, a different window is going to appear. Now, this window actually gives you the same options of different table types and graph types as before. However, you are also given a few additional options to choose from, which would be useful once you've already started analyzing your data. However, if you feel that the other window was a little bit easier for you to use, you could always go here and create a new data table and graph. And by doing that, you'll see that this window will appear, and you'll be given a fresh start so you can choose again. One last thing worth mentioning is that Prism comes with a number of different sets of sample data, which you can use in order to learn how to set up tables and graphs for various analyses. For example, if you would like to perform a one-way ANOVA, you could select this set of sample data, and Prism will open up a sample table and graph for you to use as a learning tool for setting up your own table and graph for a one-way ANOVA analysis. The sample data comes with a note explaining how the table is set up, what the goal of the analysis is, and instructions for how to analyze this type of data. In summary, looking at the sample data that most closely resembles the type of data that you want to analyze can be a very helpful way to learn how to use Prism. In the next video, we're going to show you how to add data to your table, and from that table, very easily create a really nice looking graph. If this tutorial was helpful, please click the like button below and share it with others. Also, you could subscribe to our channel for updates when new videos are released. Thanks for watching.